نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة فكشف الله به الأمة فجزاه الله عنا خير ما جازى نبيا عن أمته وداعيا عن دعوته ثم أما بعد يقول الله عز وجل في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون صدق الله العظيم. ثم أما بعد we thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We praise him as Allah should be praised. The translation of the ayah that I read to you, which is located towards the end of Surah Al-Hashr, that comes right before mentioning that beautiful back-to-back names of Allah Azza wa Jalla. You know, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر. Subhanallah amma yushrikun. Before this ayah, two, three ayat, if you go to the top of the page, it starts with, O you who believe, be God-fearing, be mindful of God, be godly people. Avoid Allah's wrath and punishment and seek Allah's pleasure. It's all engulfed and encompassed in the word ittaqullah. But this ayah is very interesting because this one ayah has the word or the command ittaqullah twice, not once. So this is how it works. O you who believe, ittaqullah, be mindful of Allah. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. So there's two parentheses. Ittaqullah, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. Within the same ayah. What is in between? What did Allah say in between these two? Ittaqullah, Allah said, and let every nafs see what it had prepared for tomorrow. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ. Let every soul, nafs, see what it had prepared for tomorrow. So now you think, what is tomorrow? So, as the word tomorrow is open-ended, obviously you will find that Ahlul Tafsir and the way the Sahaba understood it, understood tomorrow, which means, obviously, the rest of your life. What are you preparing for tomorrow so that tomorrow is better than today? But most of the Mufassirin went for tomorrow, meaning the last day. That is the first day, and in life you live 2 days, the first day and the last day. اليوم الأول واليوم الآخر. اليوم الأول is this dunya. اليوم الآخر, once you resurrect, that's the اليوم الآخر. The first day and the last day. And there is no day in between. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, let one see what he or she has prepared for tomorrow. Tomorrow means life after death. Brothers and sisters, this ayah is so accurate and so relevant and so appropriate to be mentioned today, which is, inshallah, the first day of the new Hijri. There's a whole year coming. There's a whole tomorrow coming your way. So Allah's saying, be mindful and be mindful of what you have prepared for tomorrow. So the question becomes, what have you prepared for tomorrow? Brothers and sisters, the word first thing you can do to yourself in life is to lie to yourself and to hide yourself from yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Juz'u Amma, one of the most beautiful surahs, that rhymes in a beautiful way, وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا طَحَاهَا وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Allah swore in these ayat the longest qasam in the Quran. So Allah in the Quran has the liberty, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to take an oath by His creation. But His creation has no liberty except to take an oath by His name. You cannot swear or take an oath except by Allah's name. But Allah can say, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَى وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا تَجَلَّى وَمَا خَلَقَ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى إِنَّ سَعْيَكُمْ لَشَتَّى. Allah can swear by His creation, take an oath by His creation. But we can only take oath by the name of Allah. So this is the longest back-to-back oath in the Quran. The longest. Imagine, in a short surah, has the longest oath. Count with me. وَالشَّمْسِ وَضُحَاهَا وَالْقَمَرِ إِذَا تَلَاهَا وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَغْشَاهَا وَالسَّمَاءِ وَمَا بَنَاهَا وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا طَحَاهَا وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. 7 to 8 qasam back-to-back. Interestingly, this long in which Allah says, I swear by the sun and its daylight morning, by the moon when it comes after the sun at night, by the day when it brings clarity and people can see, by the night when it brings cover, by the sky that I have raised, and by the earth that I have made inhabitable to people, and by the one who created the nafs, and by the one who inspired to your nafs what is right and what is wrong. So here is Allah dictates a fact in the Quran that Allah has put in you what we call in human language common sense. You know what's right, come on. You know what's wrong. Allah in the Quran said, the human knows what's wrong with him or her. You know what's wrong with you, even though you like to make excuses. Oh, but I was, but you know what's wrong with you. But you know what does the human do to himself? The human has the capacity, and this is categorized with psychiatrists as a condition in which you lie so much that you start developing the ability to lie to yourself. So what did Allah say after 8 qasam that ended up by the structure of the nafs? What did Allah say? قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَ وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ نَسَّاهَ. Successful is he who purifies himself. Loser is he who hides himself. What is this word hides? Why the word hide? You would think Allah would say, successful is he who purifies himself. Loser is he who makes himself filthy. No, that's not what Allah said. Allah said the one who hides himself. Which is, you start hiding yourself from yourself. Which means, you start saying there's nothing wrong with me. The whole family is telling you, Baba, you have a short temper. You get angry easily. Baba, can you calm down? There is nothing wrong with me. Why? Are you an angel? Do you not get hungry? Do you not get thirsty? Do you not get upset? Are you an angel? Are you not a man or a woman? Are you an angel? It's okay, we all get angry. But the best of us, the one who controls the anger. The whole world is talking to you. Mama, you're spending too much money. Whatever we make is gone. مَا كُلُّ مَا تَشْتَهِي تَشْتَرِي. Sayyidina Umar al-Khattab said, not everything you desire, you buy. I like it, I buy it. And now, subhanAllah, in the old days, in the Stone Age, when you checked out on Amazon, you have to type your name, your address, your credit card, expense. Now, quick, one-click checkout. Just buy it, don't even this nafs, Allah said in the Quran, and loses it. So what happens? People come and give you an advice, but what do? You hide yourself from yourself. There is nothing wrong with you, you hide it. Allah say, get to know yourself, get to know your problems, fix it, and you will be successful. I will help you. Allah tells you, I will help you. Don't hide. Don't say there is nothing wrong with you. So now, brothers and sisters, we are approaching a whole new Hijri year. I wanted to think in my head, what advice, practical advice that I can give you. You know how people say New Year resolution, this and that, so make a list and write a list. That's good. I do recommend you to make a list, and if you write that list, you are a big time successful person. They made a study at Harvard. They made a study on the people in the 1950s. And they came back and checked with them in the late 1970s, 30 years later. From the beginning of the 50s, the 60s, and the end of the 70s. So, two groups of people, and we're talking about 100 here and there, and they saw which group is more successful and what's the difference. This group was successful, this group was not as successful. The difference? The group that wrote their goals on a piece of paper actually ended up doing it. The one who didn't write it didn't accomplish anything. Simple. I'm talking about science. That's why Allah said, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم. Write. Allah will teach you. علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. If you hold the pen and write your goals, Allah will interfere, Allah will help you, and will teach you that which you don't know. عَلَّمَ الْإِنسَانَ مَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ. Taught the human what he knows not. But before, brothers and sisters, before we get into the details, make this goal and that goal, and this goal and that goal, there has to be something that precedes that. I have to ask myself, and you have to ask yourself, deep inside you, what do you want? Very simple question. What do you want? What do you want from yourself? What do you want from your family? What do you want from your money? You made money, stored it in the bank, bought properties, alhamdulillah. Inshallah, all with the blessings of Allah, halal. Inshallah. But what do you want? Because if that question is not answered, everything else will disappear. Everything. You can write all the goals you want and it's not going to work. Brothers and sisters, us human beings, Allah created for us a self-protection mechanism. What's that self-protection mechanism? That we love ourselves. Yeah, if you get closer to fire, shy, don't touch the timbar. But he sees you touching it. But he cannot tell that you're handling it from top, not from the bottom. Don't touch the timbar. But I want to touch it. Don't touch the timbar. I want to touch it. Don't. Then he touches it. And then he screams so loud, runs around the house, you have to put the ice back. Now for the rest of his life, he will not touch that teapot. Why? Because Allah put in us, we love ourselves and we like to protect ourselves from harm. We like to protect ourselves from harm. Allah put that in us. You see harm, you run away. By the way, do you know that that's the definition of taqwa? You know what's taqwa? Taqwa is running away from harm. Taqwa means avoidance, to avoid harm. So, we are born with taqwa. We're born with taqwa. But the human, when he grows up, reaches to a level where instead of his intellect, support his taqwa, because Allah tells you, don't drink. Why? Because you should have taqwa. Because drinking will harm you. Don't drink, this will kill you. Okay, I love myself. I already ran away from harm. Just like when someone says, don't jump into this 100 feet drop. You say, of course I'm not going to jump. I don't. What are you going to kill me? I'm not going to do that. Same thing. Allah says, don't drink alcohol. Don't intoxicate your body. Don't take narcotics. Don't gamble. Don't eat blood. Don't eat pork. Don't steal. Don't charge the riba. All for self-protection mechanism and the protection of the other human beings around you. So Allah is asking you to activate what He already put in you. So the human grows up, thinks he's intellectual. All animals, you know animals? They eat from a plant. It gives them stomach ache. They will never eat from that plant. They will mark its scent and its taste, and they will never eat it again. The human grows, become an adult, takes a plant, smokes that plant, his brain smokes out, he almost goes through near-death experience, and then he says, wow, that was very good, let me do it again. An animal will not do that. An animal will not do that. A human will suspend his mind and go through that. What has happened to you? That's why when Allah says in the Quran, they are like animals. People who act like that, they are like animals. No, they are worse than animals, because animals will not do that. Animals will not inflict self-harm on themselves. When was the last time you saw a monkey, forget a human, taking a blade and cutting himself? What are you doing? I'm cutting. They're so proud of it. What is this? You understand? So when Allah Azza wa Jalla suspends this thing that Allah put in us, you love yourself, that's why you eat. You don't starve yourself to death. You love yourself so that you stay away from harm. This love yourself in the mind of the human grows and grows and grows and grows, and it grows wrong. So the human starts loving himself so much that he wants to live his life for the sake of himself. Are you following? The human start living his life for the sake, not of Allah, but for himself. So here becomes the plan. I'm going to show them. You're talking to yourself. I'm going to show them. Show who? People. Show them what? I'm going to work so hard. I'm going to make money. I'm going to buy the best house. You should buy a house just for you and your family. You don't need to. No, I'm going to show them. I'm going to start it. I'm going to show them. Show them what? I'm going to start a business and make so much money. I'm going to show them. And what does the human get? Gets into this mood, I want to build glory and legacy for myself. So that I can show them, show people who I am and how successful I can be. So now, what's the mission statement of your life? Self-worship. What did Allah say in the Quran? Haven't you seen the one who took his own desires as his own God? And Allah misled him with knowledge. He has knowledge, but he still got misled. Because he decided, I'm going to live my life to build a glory and legacy for myself. You either do that, or you say, I am here to build a glory and legacy for Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. And there is no third option. So, in the beginning of this new Hijri year, you need to ask yourself, what do you want? What do you want? Are you here to build glory and legacy for yourself? What do you want? Why are you doing what you're doing? Wallahi ya Shaykh, I want to get married, please help me. Why? Because I want to get married. Can you have a better intention? Can you have a better intention? I want to get married for the sake of Allah and for my own sake, to have a partner, to have a good Muslim family so that I can bring beautiful. I want to have children, ya Shaykh. Why do you want to have a child? Allah shows us in Surah Al-Imran, the mother of Maryam, she said, Ya Allah, I want a baby so that I can give the baby to you to serve in your house. That's why I want a baby. Zakariya is crying, Ya Allah, give me a baby so that the knowledge that you gave me, I can give to him so that he can carry the mission and serve you. They have a goal. Even when they want a son or daughter, they have a reason why they want a son or daughter. Not just to have 12 children and show them what I will show them. Show what? I'm going to have a basketball team. I'm going to have a soccer team. 12, inshallah, I'm going to have 12. And you might have 12 children, and as Allah told us in the Quran, sometimes your own children turn against you and become your own enemy. The wealth, I'm going to show them, you make a lot of money. Allah says, O you who believe, know that amongst your children and amongst your wealth, an enemy for you, so beware of them. You accumulate wealth, and this wealth right now is your enemy. How? You go to sleep, the wealth will not believe you. Wake up, check the stock market. You want to eat? Don't eat. Wait. No time to talk to the family. Turn on your phone. You're going to go walk in the market? No. Sit down and watch the news so that you can analyze. that your wealth start eating up your life as if you have an enemy sitting next to you and his job is to bother you every second of your life. And that is your own wealth. So Allah said, O you who believe, know that amongst your own children, amongst your own wealth, is an enemy for you, so beware of them. So back to the same question, what do you want? What do you want? What do you want from life? Why do you want to live one more day? Why do you want to make one more dollar? Why do you want to do what you want to do? Why do you want to have family? Why do you want to have children? Why do you want to have a house? Why are you alive? If you answer that question like Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they were living it, but Allah told them to say something so that you and I will learn from their way of life. قل, say, إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Say, my prayers, my rituals, my life, and my death for Allah رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. No partners do I associate with them. I'm not here for the sake of Allah, and for the sake of myself, and for the sake of people, and for the sake of shaitan, and for the sake of fame, and for the sake of 3,000 clicks on my Facebook. I'm not alive for that. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. All for Allah, with no partners, not even me. وَبِذَٰلِكَ أُمِرْتُ, and that's what I have been commanded by my Lord. وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and I'm the first Muslim. Look at us, brothers and sisters. Each and every one of us today, and each one, every one of you has a problem. Some of you, is my health is bad. The other one is my wealth. I can't get a job. My husband is bothering me. My wife is not listening to me. My children are like giving me a hard time. Everybody has a problem. Of course. Because when you don't have a big problem, all the small problems will become big problems. Allah Azza wa Jalla in Al-Quran, can you give us a big problem? Big problem. You are here to be my agent. You are here to take care of yourself, take care of humanity, take care of earth, apply my will, give charity, do good work, serve with your own hands, put your health, wealth, time, energy, everything in you, for goodness, to make my name the highest name. That's your job. So you're like, oh my God, that's a bigger problem. So then, you know, someone comes to bother you. Oh, but I want this. You're like, listen, I wish I can pay attention to you, but now I have a big problem. I have to do something big. But when you don't have anything big, the smallest problems, you will lose sleep. Smallest issue in your life becomes a big issue. Smallest argument between a husband and wife becomes a reason for a divorce. Smallest disagreement between parents and children becomes a reason that the family will fall apart. Why? Because nobody has goals. Nobody's working for a big goal. The whole family doesn't have a meeting once a week. What are we doing for the biggest goal that Allah gave us? Are we learning our deen? Are we practicing our deen? Are we going to the masjid? Are we serving people in the masjid? Are we serving the non-Muslims? Are we talking about Islam? Are we helping our brothers, collecting donations for our brothers in Burma? You have something to keep you busy, something to get you going. You go to work, you come back from work, you have something to do. Are we reading the book of Allah? Are we understanding it? Are we making tafsir? Is everybody here explaining something to everybody? You have a big problem. Now, small problems, you know? Oh, I said to you good morning this morning, you didn't reply. Who got time for that? A whole other year coming, which means you're closer to death by 1 year. For little children, that's okay, you know? They make whatever, birthday, something, and we ask them, how many surahs did you memorize from the Quran last year? Oh, I memorized 5 surahs. Okay, inshallah, we'll bring you a cake and this. Sahaba used to do that. When their children used to finish memorizing a juzuk, or memorizing a surah, or sometimes memorize the Quran, they used to slaughter a camel, or a cow, or a sheep, and invite everybody, celebrating that my son did something fi sabilillah. That's okay. But you're growing older right now. You're still celebrating birthday. You're closer to 1 year. What are you? you celebrating? For children, that's okay. For adults, you gotta wake up. A whole new year is about to come, to dawn on you. What is your plan, brothers and sisters? What is your plan? This ummah, Muslim ummah, is made of individuals. Each Muslim individual is a cell. Your body is made of cells. One cell mutates in your body, start growing out of control, now you have cancer. What is cancer? One cell decides to not listen to the rest of the body. The body usually kills these cells. Every day, your body kills between 10 to 100 cells that are potential cancer. Every day, Allah saves you from cancer. That's body functioning as normal. Immune system, it has spies, it finds which this, it goes and spies on them and it kills them before they grow. One cell goes crazy, the whole body dies. And look at the ummah today. How many mutations, how many cancers do we have in the ummah? This ummah is made of individuals. You fix yourself, you fix your family, you come and support your masjid. We have here a successful institution, alhamdulillah, now the liver of the ummah is not sick. Next, the kidneys of the ummah is not sick. Next, the stomach of the ummah. Very soon you will find a healthy ummah that is doing what it's supposed to do. But it all starts with you. What are your goals for next year? If your goal is to serve Allah, build a legacy for Allah, build a monument for Allah Azza wa Jal, then go ahead, set your goals, and set a plan how to reach these goals. But if you have any other goal, I really feel sorry for you. Because very soon you're going to find the money that you trusted will not be there for you. If your body decides to start mutating, you can have a million. How much did Steve Jobs have in his bank? Did it help him with his pancreatic cancer not to happen? If you trust your body will betray the trust. It will get old on you and it will get sick on you. You trust your wealth will betray your trust. You will lose the money. How many people we've seen? Bubble, bust. We are witnessing, we are in the third bubble right now. Dot-com bubble, bust. People went crazy. From millionaires to homeless. Wallahi, I saw them in my own eyes. Individuals from hundreds of millions to homeless. Trust your money, I'm telling you, your money will betray your trust. Trust people, and people will betray your trust. Trust Allah, and Allah will not betray your trust. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ On Allah, the believers shall rely. What are you trusting? What's giving you the sense of security? Well, I'm secure, I have a house, and I have a car, and I have a bank account, and I got a family, I'm all set, I'm fine, I made, got it made. It will fall on you one by one in front of your eyes. That's if Allah loves you, to wake you up so that you can only put your trust in Allah. Once you put your trust in Allah, once you live for Allah, then there's a whole year coming down on us. Starting with Muharram, and we start, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is no more fasting beloved to Allah after the fasting of Ramadan, except the fasting of Shahrullah al-Haram, this month. There is no fasting more beloved to Allah after the fasting of Ramadan than the fasting of Shahrullah al-Haram, this month. So, you're going to start your year with literally not focusing on food, no more fighting with your wife, why did she cook this and she didn't cook that and too much salt and no pepper. We're going to drop all of that. We're going to replace that with fast, with fasting. We're going to focus on the goal from the beginning of the year. We're going to focus on giving sadaqah. Our brothers and sisters in Burma deserve your support. The masjid here said next Friday, inshallah, they will collect donations for Burma. They have already given from the Zakat fund, but they want to give more. So each one should come next Friday ready. You're going to focus on your Qira'atul Qur'an, you're going to find your manhaj from the book of Allah, from the example of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You're going to gather your family and you're going to say, this coming year is not going to be like last year. We have wasted too much time. Each and every one of us in this family will read a book about Islam, and we will sit down and learn about that book from that individual in the family. So I will read this book, you read this book, and each time we sit down, different one makes different presentation. Let the family be alive. Not just, did you eat? Did you drink? Did we buy socks? Did we get some underwear? Oh, okay, alhamdulillah, we are fine. What is this? Did you do your homework? Did you take a shower? Did you brush your teeth? Okay, alhamdulillah. When will be the next time we're going to... Have you achieved your goals? Did you read your Quran? Are you better? Have you read the tafsir? Have you done this? What have you applied of Islam today? What did you give Allah in the name of Allah today? This is what you need to do as a family. So that Allah will be... have His barakah on your family. Allah said in the Quran, there is no one alone by himself, but Allah is second. There is no two, but Allah is the third. There is no four, but Allah is the fifth. Make Allah the one more member of your family, as Allah said in His book. Inshallah, wa bi'alim. Aqul ma tasma'una wa astaghfirullah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على النبي بعد اللهم يا مسبب الأسباب سبب لنا أسباب الخير يا رب العالمين. Look around you, brothers and sisters. See why people are depressed and stressed. Anxiety, phobias, fears over small things, dunya things. I'm asking you, when was the last time you had an anxiety attack because you missed your salah? In your prayers. When was the last time you got so stressed out because you found out that that month you did not give away zakah and sadaqah? When was the last time you became depressed because you know you're not talking to Allah, there's no connection between you and Allah? And you're so depressed that, Ya Allah, why you're not talking to me? I can feel it when you talk to me. Up to what time are we going to live into this silliness of being stressed and depressed and anxiety attack over small things? Not that I take anything away from the people who go through medical depression and they need to see the doctor. Please, a lot of people come to me for counseling. I say, this is not my profession, go to the doctor. I don't take away from the pain of anyone who's going through stress and depression. But again, you choose your stress and depression. You choose it. Preemptively have a bigger problem so that your small problems disappear. It's shameful. We raise your hand, please, Ya Allah, please increase my income. Please, Ya Allah, I don't have children, give me another. Please, Ya Allah, I want to get married. Please, Ya Allah, I didn't buy the car that I want to buy. Please, Ya Allah, I've been trying to buy the house. Please, Ya Allah, please, Ya Allah. And the ayah is applying on you. And amongst people, those who say, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. Amongst people, their dua is always dunya, 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 dunya. Nothing. It's not like, Ya Allah, give me a nice car, and please, Ya Allah, guide me to the straight path. Nothing. Just the car, the house, the child. I'm sick, I'm tired, I don't have money. Always dunya, dunya, dunya. And Allah said, those people will have nothing in Akhirah. Know why? Because they never asked for it. And then Allah said, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Amongst people, those who say, Allah, give us in dunya, not dunya, give us in dunya hasana, something good, halal. Make me content with whatever you give me. This is hasana. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا. They make dua always for their dunya because we're human beings and we need Allah's help. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينُ. And they make dua for akhirah. Look at your dua, brothers and sisters. What are you crying to Allah for? Always dunya. Why? This is a new beginning. First day of the Hijri year. You have to wake up. If you are 13 years old and older, if you are 10 years old and older, you're not a child anymore. If they're telling you you're still a baby, they're lying to you. You're not a child, you're not a baby, you are a young man and a young woman. So man up. and woman up and become something that you aspire to be in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والأحيين والأموات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك قريب سميع مجيب الدعوات. اللهم أعز دين الإسلام وانصر دين المسلمين وأعلم بنا كلمة الحق والدين واجعلنا من عبادك الصالحين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحم إخواننا المسلمين في بورما يا رب العالمين، وارحم إخواننا المسلمين في كشمير وفي أفغانستان، وارحم إخواننا المسلمين في فلسطين يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم إخواننا المسلمين في سوريا ومصر وليبيا واليمن يا رب العالمين. ارحم إخواننا المسلمين في أفريقيا وفي الصين. ارحم إخواننا المسلمين في بوسنة وفي الشيشان يا رب العالمين وفي كل مكان يا أرحم الراحمين. ارحم إخواننا المسلمين في العراق وأردنهم من بعد خوفهم أمنا يا رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم آمين. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء